Okay. So we now know about page layout, right? One more thing that you can actually do with a page layout is you can have different page layouts for different profiles, right? So what you can do is for let's say you have a sales profile and you have a customer support profile, right? And you want to have a different type of page layout for both the teams. Let's say, I mean, the requirements can be like that, right? The sales team wants to see maybe the contact information of the company at the top, and the customer support team wants to see the cases information, you know, the tickets raised by the company at the top. So the requirements can be different, right? Now, what you can do is you can have different page layouts designed for the same object, and then you can assign it to different profiles. So page layout assignment is simple. You just have to for standard object you have to go to setup, customize, and select the object, and then click on page layout. For example, for opportunities, you just have to go to setup, customize, opportunities. It should be opportunities and then page layout, actually. Opportunity product is a different object. And for custom object, you just will need to go to setup, create objects, select the object, and then go to page layout. And it's pretty simple. I'll just show you an example. Okay, so let me just show you an example of page layout assignment for, let me take opportunities. So you go to setup, customize, and then go to opportunities, and then you click on the page layout. Here it is. Okay, so there are two things. When you have the list of page layouts for this object, because this is a standard object, you already have 1, 2, 3, 4 page layouts. And if you can see, marketing layout, sales layout, support layout. Okay, so you can have, you know, you can give them different names and you can create multiple page layouts. Now, why will we create multiple page layouts? Just to assign them to different profiles. And how do we do the assignment? We just click on page layout assignment. Simply click on page layout assignment. Now you see there is a complete list of all the profiles. All the profiles are listed here, and your page layouts are listed here. So which profile sees which page layout is listed here. If you want to edit, just click on edit, assignment, and select to make any changes. Let's say this marketing user, this is a profile. We see opportunity layout here. If you want to change this, okay. So this is what we have to do in page layout assignment. Simple thing. Same thing is applicable for custom object page layouts also. So in custom object, you just have to go to setup, create objects, just go to setup, create objects, and then you have to click on the object for which you want to define the page layout. Select that object. If you scroll down a little, you will see the page layouts. Here it is. For custom object, by default there is one page layout which gets created when you create the custom object. and you always have that option of creating more page layouts and then assigning them to the profiles the way you want. Clear? Okay. So now let's move on to the next thing. So that's about page layout and page layout assignment. Now let's understand about record types. Now record type is an important concept. Record types allow you to offer different business processes with list values and page layouts to different users for different types of records in the same object. Got it? So it allows you to offer different business process with list values and page layouts to different users for different types of records. So in the same object, if you are trying to store two different types of records, then you can create record types. For example, you have let me just give you an example which is pretty simple. Think of it, you are running a business, a business where you track contact information, and you have two types of contacts. One is a buyer, one is a seller. Okay, so both of them will go into the contacts. Okay, but for buyer you need different type of information, whereas for seller you want different types of information. You know, the information which is which you need to store, more or less you need the same information for both of them or similar kind of information, but it will be different. In you know, certain pick list values will be different for the buyer and for the seller. Like for buyer, what is he willing to buy? For the seller, what is he willing to sell? For the buyer, it will be the address information. For seller, it will be the product information. So some fields will be specific type of record. Some fields will be specific to the type of record, right? Sometimes these kind of situations you will come across, right? Or if you are selling a product to companies as well as individuals, okay, if you are into selling products to businesses as well as consumers, then what will happen? You again will have this thing, two types of accounts: individual accounts and company accounts, right? Personal account, that is what it is called, right? Because from any person where you are taking money, you have to create an account for that, right? So when there is an individual customer that you have to store different types of information for that individual customer. But if it is a company, then you will need a different type of information for it, right? So that is the record type. So whenever we have this kind of situation that there are two different record types which are available for the same object, we create record types. Okay. Creating record type is pretty simple. For standard object, you just need to go to setup, customize, select the standard object. Okay. And for custom objects, you can just go to setup, create object, select the custom object and create the record type. So let's create a record type. For example, okay, we have created this project object. Okay, let's take an example. Okay. So let me just take a very simple example here. We have this project object, okay? Now your company takes two types of project: consulting and auditing projects. Let's say. Alright. Now, for consulting project, you need different set of information. Consulting project is also a project, audit project is also a project. But for consulting project, the kind of information you need is different. For audit project, the type of information you need to store is different. Okay. So let's say for consulting project, I'll just take a simple example. In consulting project, you have a subcategory which can be either into strategy consulting, management consulting, for audit you have, let's say, two different subcategories. This is just one example that I'm actually trying to give. In audit you can have, let's say, risk management audit, insurance audit. Okay. Now you can go to setup, create objects, as I told you. Come here to that project object, scroll down a little more. Record types you will get to see here. Okay. Now you can create new record type here. So my first project is consulting record type. Okay, which all profiles will get to see this record type? I make it visible for all the profiles at this point of time. So you have the choice that certain profiles will only get to see one of the record types. That option you have. You can just define it here. Which page loads you want to assign for which profile for this record type? So we just have one page layout here, so we are not gonna get, you know, confused on that, because for different profiles, different record types, you can have different page layouts. Okay, so we just have one page layout, so life is easier. Just save it. All right. Consulting. Now there is one more record type which I want to create here, which is the audit page layout. No, sorry, audit record type. There's one more record type which we will create here, which is audit. Consulting we have already created. Create this as audit. This also active. We can be for profiles. Next. Save. So now we have two record types for projects, and both of them are active. Now if you go to project, try to create a new project. the system will ask you a question whether you want to create a project with audit or consulting record type. Now if you go to audit and click on continue, now you have that option of having a different page layout here. Category, subcategory. So for example, for this audit page, you if you go here, if I go and show you the page layout thing, you will just notice that. The two record types have been created. Now go back to your page layout and see. Now if you click on page layout assignment, see, one is the master record type, one is the audit, one is the consulting, okay? And you have the option of defining different page layouts for different record types for different profiles, right? So for example, if you have 10 fields on this project object, all the fields will need to be created on project object. Let's say there are 10 fields, and out of 10 fields, 5 fields are related to consulting thing, and 5 fields are related to this thing. You might need to store different information, right? In consulting project, you might need to store the start date, end date. In audit project, you might need to store something else. So you can have different field sets for them, and have the different page layouts where you make the fields visible or not visible, and you can have that sort of setting. Correct. So that is the main advantage of using a record type. All right, but it's always advisable to select it properly, whether you need a different record type. So this is a good thing to analyze it a little, whether you actually need a record type or you need a different object, right? So you might be thinking at this point of time that while we have different field sets, then why are we getting into this record type concept? Why are we not getting into two different objects, right? So the reason is pretty simple. One, because you might still have some common fields, okay? Your relationships might be the same. For example, a project is something which will be related to other things also, right? Like the consultants and the clients. Now if you create 4 project fields, then how will you create the relationships there, right? So that is something that you have to understand, that your relationships, how your database is related. That is one question that you have to ask yourself. Second thing is, do you have common fields? I mean, if you have common fields, then only record type matters. If all the fields are different, then there is no point actually having the record type. Third thing that we have to understand, record type sometimes becomes an important thing if you do not want to have too many objects. For project itself, if I create 3-4 objects, 3-4 types of projects, and for everything I create a different object, end of the day I will create a system which is having too many objects. And for custom objects, again you have a limitation, right? For every addition, there is a limitation for how many custom objects you can have, right? So for that reason also, so all these reasons you have to consider, right? The relationship you will have to look into, is there actually a similarity, or are we trying to put two completely different things in the project, in the same object? That is something which we have to understand. On the same lines, you can have record types for your clients, competitors, and maybe suppliers or vendors. Right, partners. You can have those, but you have to, you know, first of all, do a good analysis to understand whether you need four different record types here, or can you just manage with a drop down field. A good example is here. I created two record types. I mean, I showed you two record types for audit and consulting, and I see that we have also created a category field here, audit consulting. So you have to understand the requirement, whether you need a record type or this kind of a field type is also okay. So based on that, you can actually decide. Correct? So that's about our record types. And you can have different page layouts for different record types. Now let's go and talk about email templates. Email template is simple thing. I mean, there is nothing very new in it. I think you might have created certain email templates, or you sometimes create a draft email and save it, right? So more or less similar to that. Here the only difference is that you create a template, you save it, and then we will use it a little later when we are you know, sending automated emails and all those things. You can use those templates to send the emails and all. So you can create four different types of email templates in Salesforce. Text email template, all users can create or change text email templates. Okay, the text email template is something which all users can create and change, and the text email template is a basic email template where you cannot do any formatting, plain text basically. Okay, normal, no formatting, no colors, nothing. HTML with letterhead, this is an email template which administrators and users with the edit HTML template permission can create. So any user who has this edit HTML template permission on the profile can create HTML email template. Okay, HTML with letterhead email template is where you can do the text formatting, the colors, the size, the font, bringing in the links, pictures in the email template. So that sort of thing. So all the sort of designing can be done here. Then there is custom HTML. So this is again something where the user needs to have edit HTML template permission and can create this HTML email templates. And this is where you can do the formatting. So what is the difference between the second one and third one? In the second one you will have the formatting palette. In the third one you can format using writing HTML codes. So you have to write HTML code to do the formatting for this third one. You must either know HTML or obtain the HTML code to insert in your email template. So this third one is only, it does you know, recognize only HTML code. And the next one is Visual Force email template. So Visual Force email template is something which administrators and developers can create templates using Visual Force. So this is something which you create using Visual Force. This is something which we will discuss later once we get into the Visual Force part. Okay. So let me just go and show you how these email templates are created. So go to Setup. I'll just show you a little, you know, overview how to get into that, I would ask you guys to actually go spend some time and create it. It's very simple. So go to communication template, email templates, setup, communication template, email templates. In that, just go ahead and click on new template. Decide which template you want to use, text or HTML or which one, and then click on next. Okay, once you've decided the email template, you will get this option. Then you can just fill in the name and unique name of the email template, make it available for the use, put in a subject line and email body. So because this is a plain text email template, there is no formatting, nothing available here, right? No formatting options. Whatever you will write will be written in plain text format. Only thing you need to understand in an email template is including the merge fields. Let's say you want to send this email to certain contacts, right? Then what you have to do? You might want to merge the contact first name or something here. After hi, you might want to write the first name of the contact. So you just will select the object field. The moment you select the object and field, you will get some value here, a formula here. You just copy that, put it here. That's what we have to do. So wherever we need a merged field value means a dynamic value, we will put this formula from here instead of writing something new, because you do not know the person who will receive what is his name. So you will just take it from there. After writing all the story, you want to say regards and you want to put the user information here, sending user fields. Copy this and put it here. So this will be the sending username. Got this thing? So this is how you can create an email template. Put subject line and all these things and click on save. Right, so this is a plain text one. Similarly, you can create the other ones as well. You click on new template. You can create one using letterhead. So for creating this second type of email template, first of all, you will have to go and create a letterhead, because this uses a letterhead. So you just have to go to communication template, click on letterheads, and then go to next, and then you just have to click on new letterhead and create the letterhead. If you want, you can edit all these things and see, edit the background color and all these. Save it, then try to create the second email template with the letterhead. So letterhead we have already created. You can just select this one, HTML using letterhead, and start creating this. The moment you create this email template, it will ask you of all the same information what you provided there, but it will also ask you for a letterhead, and in addition to all that information, it will ask you for the letterhead. So letterhead we have already created. So this is where you have that formatting option. This is the email template where you put the subject and the body, but while writing the body, you have all the formatting options available. Right, so in case you want to design an email template with images, pictures, all that stuff, then go with this option. third option that we have here is the custom email template. Custom email template without using letterhead, this is the one where you have to write HTML code. So if you know HTML code, you will just go here. Click on next and then you will you will write the HTML body here, the code body here. Okay, so that is how it works. Clear on that? So that is how we work on the email templates. So take out some time, try to create a few email templates. Now what do we do with these email templates? Once we have created the email templates, why do we need the email templates to be there in the system? You can do Salesforce allows us to do some mass mailing, so it gives us an option of sending mass emails, but that mass email option is not for sending thousands of email on a day or something like that. Mass mailing option that Salesforce provides is for a very less number of emails that you can send actually. So Salesforce is not a mass mailing tool. For sending mass emails for your marketing, emailers and all those things, you will use something else. So Salesforce is not the right solution for that. Okay. So don't use Salesforce for sending mass emails as such. But sometimes if you just want to send something to 10-15 people, that is what Salesforce allows. Okay. In a day, they allow you approximately 100 emails to be sent. So, and that too depends on your edition as well. For developer edition, I think they will allow you only to send 10 emails in a day. So don't think that Salesforce can be used for the marketing emailers or something. Yeah, it can help you send some email. Let's say you want to just send a quick communication to all your users, 5, 10, 50 of them. So it will allow you to send that. So for these kind of small mass mailings which are allowed by Salesforce, or if you just want to send a quick email to all the leads that have been generated today, that is something which can be done, right? So if today's leads you just want to send an email, that is something which can be done. Now Salesforce basically allows you to automate some of the processes as well. Like apart from sending mass emails, you can also have these automated emails being sent. Automated email being sent means where let's say there is a record created and automatically an email is sent to the contact saying that, hey, hi, you have inquired for this product and this is what is the catalog, please have a look. So if you want that kind of an automated email, which is something which we are going to do in tomorrow's session, in our next session we are going to discuss about that, right? So for these kind of situations you will need the email templates to be saved. So the email template should be there in the place before you can send a mass email or automate some email sending process. So let's talk a little about mass emails. Let's see how this mass email can be sent. You can send a mass email message to a recipient list that consists of contacts, leads or person accounts. So mass email option is available for only these objects. Contact, leads, person accounts and users. Right, so these are the objects, these are all standard objects. You cannot do mass mailing to any of the custom objects. When I say you cannot do mass emailing to custom objects, Salesforce by default has not provided any such option. You can still do it using your own automation or customization. That is something which we can do, but that is not default functionality of Salesforce. We can write program to do that. So to mass email to contacts, click mass email contacts in the tools section at the bottom of the contacts. For sending it to leads, you just have to say, you know, click at the tool section at the bottom of the leads tab. So if you just want to send a mass email to contacts or leads, you just have to go to the tab and there you will see a tool section. Let me show this to you. For example, you want to send a mass email to some contacts. So go to contacts. Now from contacts you have the tool section. Here you will have mass email contacts. See this? Click on mass email contacts. Then go to next. Sorry, first of all select the contacts that you want to send the email to and then select next. Let's say you just want to send email to this contact and this and this. Whichever contacts you want to send the email to, just select them and then go to next. Then select the email template. There are some of the email templates already existing. The email templates that I created, email template one, that is also available here. Select the email template, which template you want to send. You have already selected the contacts, then go and click on the next button. And you have the option of either sending it now or schedule for delivery. When do you want to send this? Then click on mass email name. Give it a name. And then you just click on send. Got this thing? So that is how, same way you can do it for leads and person accounts as well. So in the leads also you have mass email leads option available. Which leads, same option, right? Okay. So mass email is where you will use your email templates, and apart from that, automating the email sending process. You know, sometimes you might want to send an automated email on some record edit or record creation. That is where again you can use this email templates. So that is something which we are going to do in, you know, our next session, the automation thing. So that is again where we will use our email templates. Okay, any questions on this? No? Clear on this? All right. Then the other thing that we have to talk about is the Salesforce console overview. What is a console? A Salesforce console is designed to boost productivity for users. So it's just consider a Salesforce console to be a user interface. I mean, I will tell you as a, you know, user interface. So Salesforce allows you to create a different type of user interface to enhance productivity, okay, in fast-paced environments for the users. Okay, so it's designed to boost productivity for users in fast-paced environments. So if you want to, you know, provide a user interface where the users want to work in a fast-paced environment, you can create a console. So basically, console is just a different type of user interface, right? The console's dashboard-like interface improves on the user interface, so it helps you improve the user interface by eliminating time-consuming clicking and scrolling. So you can quickly find, update and create records. Alright. So console is mainly used for creating a type of user interface which reduces your clicking and scrolling. Yeah. So I'll show you what exactly we are talking about. Most of the times console can be used by the customer support team. Now just think of it for a while. If you have a sales team, your sales team is accessing the data through Salesforce, and if you have customer support team, they are also accessing data through Salesforce. Now the difference in approach of these two teams is sales team makes a call, so for them it's an outgoing call, and they gather information because they have the time to, you know, gather all the information and then make a call. But when it's a customer support team, someone who is sitting in the customer support team, that person is not aware that who is going to call, right? He receives the call and then he gets to know which client is calling, and then he cannot put the client on hold for a longer time, right? He has to answer the client queries very quickly. So that is the thing. Now the sales team and the customer support team basically has this difference that sales team still has time, customer support team does not have time, so they need to navigate things faster, right? So most of these times these consoles are required by the support people, support teams. How to create a console, I'll show you. So they have recently introduced this console option. It's easy to create. It's more like a custom object, custom application that we have created. You can create it by clicking on setup, create apps. Okay, so you just have to go to setup, create apps, and there you will click on new. And when you click on new, you always have an option of either creating a custom app or console. So you will select a console here. So once you select the console, click on next. Let me call it support. So it's more like a custom app only, right? Only the user interface is different. Go to next. Okay. Accounts, contacts, opportunities. Include all these things here. Go to next. Okay, so let's say I want to include four things: case, account, contact, opportunity. Now I have the option of defining some the objects as primary tabs or sub tabs. So contact, cases I make it as sub tab of account. Contact should be a sub tab of account. Opportunity should also be sub tab of account. Right, so account is a primary tab, and these three are sub tabs, right? And then I click on next, save it. Same old profile assignment, save it. Done. So my console is created. Now you just go and see here, support console has been created. Now see what is the difference between the custom object and the console. The user interface is different. The way a custom object, custom app looks, and the way this console looks, the UI part is different, right? You have the tabs like this. Cases, account, contact, opportunity, you don't have the tabs spread here. Then you click on accounts, it will show you all the accounts. Click on one of the accounts, it will open it. Then if you want to open a contact, you can click on this and you will see that it has not closed the account. The account is open, The contact has got opened as a sub tab of the account. So account details are also there. Now open an opportunity. That also opens up as a sub tab of the account. The account is still there. Now you open a case. So if you are in the customer support team and if you have got a call from this client, and if you have to navigate through different informations of this client, from an opportunity to the contact or this thing, you can quickly navigate. I mean, you don't have to close it. In custom app, what happens in our apps, usually what we have seen, if I click on account and then I click on contact, the account is gone and I enter into the complete contacts page. Again, if I have to come back to account, again I have to go and click on the account. Now it's nothing is getting closed, everything is here. Fine, and it's all Ajax functionality which is helping you switch from one record to the other record or the parent record, child record very quickly. Then you will think of other case you have to look into. So these are the tabs and sub tabs. So accounts, because we selected them as primary tabs, accounts get opened as primary tabs and everything else is getting opened as a sub tab because I selected them as sub tab there. For this thing, so you can have 2-3 layers of records here. Under contact, again, if you had something else as sub tab, that would have opened up here. So that is the thing. So that's the advantage of our console, right? So wherever you feel that this is required by your team, you can design in console and give it to the team. Alright,